In Persona 5 Royal, you meet a variety of unique and colorful characters, but none is more of an enigma than our very own Yusuke Kitagawa. The pupil of Madarame and a member of the Phantom Thieves, this mysterious and yet passionate artist is one of the most memorable characters from Persona 5. And today in our analysis, we'll be looking at his personality, design, and usefulness in combat a bit more in depth to determine just how great of a character Yusuke is, ranking him out of 5 for each to see how he compares to other Persona characters across the games. Let's get started. Firstly, I'd like to start with personality. And honestly, where should I even begin with this one? Yusuke is truly one of the most curious and intriguing characters I've ever had the pleasure of meeting in a game. He's interested and passionate about the most wild things, and his interactions with the wider world around him often make up many of the funniest scenes in Persona 5. As I'm sure you know, he's incredibly devoted to his artwork, and combined with his incompetence with money, he's willing to spend a vast amount of money on the wildest things in the pursuit of beauty and art. He buys lobsters, he buys food he doesn't need, he buys an overabundance of painting supplies. The dude is stubborn and doesn't care, and will starve if he has to in the pursuit of true, beautiful art. While he can be a bit over the top, Yusuke is also a caring friend to his fellow Phantom Thieves members. He's supportive of their struggles throughout the game, especially Futaba's, and he also helps out the team in many ways, such as by providing them his artistic talent to create the iconic Phantom Thieves logo. His curious nature often leads to him thinking outside the box when they're stuck in a jam, helping out the team immensely with his different ways of thinking. His passion for art is what leads to his destined encounter with Ren, Ryuji, and An, where he funnily begs An to be his model. This is where Yusuke's role in the story begins, and his initial arc, as most are in this game, was fantastic. He's trapped with Madarame, fighting between believing whether he is truly terrible or not, and he can't push himself to leave. Upon learning of Madarame's true nature and the many terrible actions he committed, including the indirect murder of Yusuke's own mother, Yusuke rightfully rebels and condemns him, joining the Phantom Thieves. His confidant continues this story, showing how his encounter with the disgusting Madarame and the terrible acts that humanity is capable of have tainted his own art and clouded his judgment and values. Yusuke's confidant was one of the most interesting to me personally, as it really showed Yusuke's struggle to move on. And unlike most other characters, through his confidant, he sort of even forgave Madarame to a small extent. Despite denouncing Madarame completely during his awakening, he seems to struggle to completely denounce him afterwards, as he recognizes the good times he had with Madarame on occasion, and that Madarame, like most humans in general too, was not born bad and was once a good soul, but was at some point tainted in some way by something, leading him down a dark path. All of this makes Yusuke a truly interesting character in my opinion. A deep artist who on the surface is wacky, charming, and funny, but deep down struggles with many philosophical questions and thoughts about morality and humanity. I give Yusuke a 5 for personality. He's a character with many layers and a lot of depth to him, and truly one of the most memorable people in this game. Looking at design now, and honestly, Yusuke is a handsome and very well designed character overall. With his hair color and hairstyle, he exudes a moody, yet passionate look, which is reminiscent of his actual personality. You may not have noticed, but unlike nearly every male character, Yusuke has very defined and long eyelashes, and this is actually a really interesting detail that they added. This subtle, yet meaningful change from every other male signifies that he is just a tad more artsy, dramatic, and feminine, as we see this through his passion towards beauty and the like. His outfits throughout the game are pretty good, and many of them are quite wacky to us, but are seen as experimental, innovative, and artistic in his eyes, such as his unforgettable scarf. His Phantom Thief outfit is so fitting for him, and it's topped off by the beautiful fox mask that really screams out to the player that this guy is an artist. Overall, he's a well-designed pretty boy top to bottom. And speaking of pretty boys, have you seen his concept art? Dude was gonna be prettier than every girl in Persona 5 if they hadn't changed him. I give Yusuke a solid 5 out of 5 for design. As an artist himself, I'm sure Yusuke would appreciate his own design just as much as we do as well. Our last category is combat. And Yusuke is pretty good as a party member. He wields ice magic, can increase the party's dodge and hit chance, and utilizes many physical skills, specializing in those that are powered up after a baton pass. Against normal shadows in each of the palaces, this can be very powerful and helpful, giving him a good way to land a meaty blow, especially against shadows who don't have a weakness to be knocked down by. Unfortunately, as you might have guessed, this mechanic's usefulness does not extend into boss fights very well. It's useful in only about a handful of boss fights, as many do not have weaknesses nor summon backup with weaknesses that allow for you to use a baton pass during the fight, essentially nulling out Yusuke's main unique ability. As such, in a boss fight, and arguably to an extent even outside of boss fights, Yusuke is pretty heavily outclassed by another party member, Ryuji Takasu. Ryuji Sakamoto. Ryuji in general has access to many more powerful physical skills, along with being able to buff up the party's attack, which in my opinion is much more useful than buffing evasion or hit chance. In boss fights especially, the biggest advantage Ryuji has over Yusuke though is just a single ability, Charge. Charge makes Ryuji an absolute beast in boss battles, making him capable of taking out fantastic chunks of their health easily. And this makes him worth taking over Yusuke in most cases. Now I know what some of you are thinking, actually idiot, Yusuke can learn Charge too. And yes, you're right. It's very easily missable, but if you know to go to the jazz club on a single specific night, which most people on their first playthrough don't, myself included, then Yusuke too can gain Charge. But even then, I'd still say Ryuji is better in boss fights with his superior physical skills. Let's also not forget Ryuji, through his third awakening, gets the ability to charge up the entire party, which is honestly one of the most powerful abilities in any Persona game, beat only by some of the insane Persona 3 fusion spells. Add this with the fact that most people play blind their first playthrough and don't realize the potential of the Jazz Club until it's too late, and you have many people ending up with only an alright Yusuke, who never gets to reach his full potential. As such, I'm gonna give Yusuke a solid 4 for combat. Above average, but not perfect. He's a fine party member, not a bad choice at all. And despite what I say, he's not bad in boss fights by any means. He's great, especially against shadows, but in boss fights without baton passes, there's better choices is all I'm saying. It's not like using him will lead to your death or anything dramatic like that. The fact that he can't gain charge easily and that most players will miss the chance to give him it really hurts his score in my opinion. In the future in Persona 6, I really hope they go back to a Persona 4 biking kind of system, where you always have the chance to get these special skills, instead of this one and done, miss it, and you're shit out of luck deal that they have going on with the Jazz Club right now. And so, my final score for Yusuke is 14 out of 15. Yusuke is well designed, both aesthetically and as an actual character. He's comic relief, but also an interesting soul who you really grow to love as you get to know him. And in battle, he's pretty great too. I've said it before and I'll say it again, Yusuke is one of my favorite Persona characters. He's great all around in my opinion. With that said, that's it for the video. What do you guys think about Yusuke? Do you agree or disagree with my thoughts? How would you rank him in our three categories? Let me know in the comments down below, and if you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe for more videos about all things Persona. Thanks for watching, and peace out.